taking on information and experiments is going to follow this structure, and so a brief introduction is going to be described. Physics and chemistry in the fourth grade of secondary education has the objective of literacy of students in the basic ideas of scientific method, so that students are able to solve their daily life problems for physics ideas. So that experimentation should be very present, very much present in these subjects. And in fact, teaching learning process is based on reading the book or listening to explanation only between 10 and 20% of the contents are going to be retained in long term. However, when the students are asked to talk with their classmates or to do experiments, the 70 or 90% of the contents are retained in long term. That's why this work bets on methodological innovation, fostering active learning and autonomy of the students by means of the proposal of a series of activities in which the teacher acts as a guide and makes the students protagonists of their own learning. And also learning processes in, that foster interrelationship between students. The objectives of the work are to combine experiments with innovative teaching learning approaches for the acquisition of knowledge on physics and chemistry, encourage active learning and students' initiative and autonomy, and the use of technological tools to facilitate this kind of learning. Foster cooperation, collaboration, and peer support, and enriching the teaching learning process. And finally, propose a tool of evaluation for the usefulness of these activities. The description of each experience will contain the contents covered, the timing, the innovative methodology, the objectives, and a brief description of the development. In the first proposal, the students will work with vectorial magnitudes and composition of motions, and it is proposed as a developmental activity, so for the middle of the lesson. And problem-based learning is oriented towards practical learning by means of open-ended problems that must be as real as possible, and the students will face cognitive conflicts. And they will work in a small group. The objectives in this proposal are analyze and deal with problems in the same way that they would do in their daily lives, interpret and observe the movement of an object as a composition of two uniform motions, and be able to intuit the speed with the vectorial character that it has. The development of this proposal will follow three steps. In the first one, theoretical revision of the vectorial magnitudes will be carried out. Then the students will be given a series of materials and a paper sheet with the problem statement. And then students by pairs will build the problem scenario and try to solve it using vectors. The second proposal will work the contents of frictional force and the view of other forces, and it's also proposed as a developmental activity. And this time, flipped classroom, as said before, divide the activities in between outside the classroom and inside the classroom. The activities outside the classroom are mainly based on explanatory videos with a series of questions that give feedback to the teacher to plan its next lesson, and the strategies for just-in-time teaching, and it's based on the lower thinking skills, remembering, understanding, etc. And then the activities inside the classroom are based on peer instruction and are related to the higher thinking skills, analyzing, evaluating, creating. In this case, the objectives are to be autonomous and able to self-organize time and tasks outside the classroom, review the concepts of weight and normal force, and understand frictional force. The development will also follow three steps. In the first one, the students watch a video and answer a series of questions. Then in the activities inside the classroom, they will start with a quick review with the response system, such as Socrative. And then in this case, the peer instruction activities are going to be changed by a series of experimental activities that demonstrate the courses studied. The proposal 3 is related to the atmospheric pressure, and in this case it is proposes an introductory and motivational activity. So for the first lesson, for the first session of the lesson, and in this case peer learning is used, and it aims at engaging students in their own learning by a series of conceptual questions that first they have to think individually, and then discuss with the partner to correct misconceptions and reformulate initial ideas. In this case, the objectives are recognizing the classmates, legitimate partners from whom to learn, verifying the force due to the atmospheric pressure, and reconstruct wrong conceptual schemes or verify valid ones. In this case, each student is given a sheet with a series of conceptual questions and two forms. First, each student individually will face cognitive conflicts and fill the column in the left with what they know. And then, discussing with a partner, they will build alternative schemes and fill the column on the right with what they know together. Then the whole class will talk about these concepts and will verify them with the help of the teacher. And as consolidation, a series of experimental activities are proposed to verify these concepts. In the fourth proposal, they will work contents related to heat, temperature, thermal equilibrium, and dilatation. And in this case, it is a consolidation activity, so for the last sessions of the lesson. And in cooperative learning, the teacher acts as a supervisor of the activity and creates mixed and heterogeneous groups that will have common objectives. So by sharing the work and having individual responsibility, and this kind of innovative methodology fosters interpersonal skills as well as joint reflection. In this case, the objectives are recognize cooperative learning as advantageous and useful for large tasks, and differentiate the concept of heat and temperature, observe thermal expansion, build a sensitive temperature measurement device, and the development is to make groups of four members. Each of them are going to be experts in a part of a long test, and they will have a week to become experts and to explain to the other members of the group each part. And finally, after this week, a session of the class is going to be dedicated to carry out different experiments and will be introduced by a review of these parts by members that are not experts in each of the parts. And finally, the proposal 5 is related to chemical reactions.
We should go to
Okay, the evaluation is to put a percentage of the total grade of the subject in these activities, and some questions in the exams, and a proposed questionnaire of satisfaction for students. And the conclusions are that this work contains a series of experiences that combine practical experiments with innovative teaching learning methodologies. And these experiences are based in the active learning, autonomy, and cooperation among students, and they will be introduced gradual and in a balanced way. And but the best conclusion should be the possibility